My name is Nicolas Zegre. I'm Associate Professor of Forest Hydrology in the Davis College School of Natural Resources at West Virginia University, and I'm the Director of the Mountain Hydrology Laboratory. Well, I've always been a water enthusiast, whether it's kayaking, whether it's surfing, whether it's skiing, and throughout my time growing up, I just realized the role that water had in shaping the landscape and hence shaping culture around us. Water, of course, is needed for all aspects of our modern living. Water is a basis of healthy communities and healthy ecosystems and healthy economies. West Virginia is a really unique state in the country. Water that originates in West Virginia actually provides fresh water resources for drinking and for economies for about 9 million people, which is about 3% of the U.S. population. And our research is really focused on quantifying how important West Virginia's water resources are to our local economy as well as our downstream economies that are dependent upon this water. So our work aims to understand the state of West Virginia's water resources to both identify areas that we can increase West Virginia's economy through the sustainable use of water resources now and into the future. Another aspect of our work is using our hydrologic models to understand what parts of West Virginia are expected to increase in their flooding and understand the vulnerability of communities to changes in flood regime. We have a very diverse toolkit from small-scale experimentation in the forest where we measure, for example, how many leaves are on a tree, or we measure stream flow, we measure soil moisture, we collect samples for water quality. We also use a lot of modeling. We use climate models and hydrologic models to look at where our water is going, how much of our water is going to different places, and the role that West Virginia water plays outside of the state. We believe in order to create a vibrant freshwater economy here in West Virginia that would benefit the citizens of West Virginia as well as our ecosystems, we need to use science to inform policy making to make decisions on how we could use our water for the greatest benefit for West Virginia and its people.